How you feeling?
God bless you. How you doing?
Glad to see you.
Soulful.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Called that all night tonight.
The Lord was there last night.
That was great. We heard you.
When the Apostle Peter was resting, we were going to George Monk House. Knock on the door.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We're good
and
all of it.
Let's go, Dr. King.
Well, things went fairly well. I was under the unfortunate circumstance of having a terrible cold all while I was in jail, so it was rather uncomfortable as far as that went, but as far as the treatment, by and large, the officials were very courteous. We ran into two or three hospital wardens here and there, but the other officials proved to be very courteous. We managed to get a lot of reading done, and we discussed a lot of things, so it was a spiritual experience, even though we were incarcerated.
Mrs. King said you did not receive all the medical treatment you were supposed to receive. Would you comment on that?
Well, as far as the physician was concerned, I did. The physician came every day, my private physician here in Birmingham, Dr. Montgomery, but they prescribed a lot of liquids like juices to drink, and there were times that some of the hostel wardens would not bring the juice to the room, to the cell. So we did have that problem. But other than that, the medical attention was very good.
What are your plans now, Dr. King?
Well, I'm going to Atlanta to be in my pulpit Sunday morning, and then I will go immediately from there to Cleveland to engage in a massive get-out-the-vote drive all day Monday and Tuesday for the general election, which will be taking place there on Tuesday to elect a new mayor of that city.
Any comment on Winston-Salem this morning?
No, I don't know enough about it. In fact, I just heard it. So I don't know enough about it to make any intelligent comment on it. I'll be going to Atlanta tomorrow. I'll stay over tonight for the mass meeting.
All right.
Have a chance once more to be with our friends in Birmingham. We feel that our movement here in 1963 was probably the greatest movement for freedom ever held in America, and tonight we plan to stay over for the mass meeting to feel that movement fervor once more, for we are getting ready to move out into a kind of escalated nonviolent struggle all over this country, including the District of Columbia, and we're going to need the support of our friends here in Birmingham as well as all over the country.
Specifically, Dr. King, what will you be demonstrating for here in Birmingham tonight?
No, this is just a mass meeting tonight. There will be no demonstration tonight. We will have a mass meeting. We were to be in jail until tomorrow, and the Birmingham people decided that they would have a vigil beginning at 3 o'clock this afternoon until we got out of jail, which would have lasted until tomorrow. And apparently the officials felt that they didn't want that vigil to take place, so they let us out many hours before the time that would have ordinarily taken place.
I arrived late. Maybe you've already said. If you have, sir, it won't be necessary to repeat, but how were you treated in jail? How was your stay there?
Well, on the whole, we were treated very courteously. In fact, we made some real friends in the jail among some of the wardens and some of the jailers. There were cases, I would say in two or three cases, we found hostile wardens who went out of the way to be discourteous and to say unkind things. But on the whole, I would say that the treatment was courteous, and we found, as I said, several new friends, because we talked to them about the movement and tried to educate them on what we are trying to do in this nation.
How about yourself personally? How did you spend your time?
Unfortunately, I was under the doctor's care the whole period. I had a terrible cold, a virus infection, and the doctor had to come in every day while I was there, and he urged me to get plenty rest, which meant I had to stay in the cell bunk most of the time, but I did a good deal of reading, and in fact, all of us read a great deal, and we discussed many issues concerning the movement and many spiritual matters. So as I said earlier, it was a spiritual experience, even though we were incarcerated.
Dr. King, you mentioned about moving out in a nonviolent way to other places in the country. Is this more of what you were going to, of what you were talking about at the SCLC convention, your massive civil disobedience in the North?
That's correct. I haven't announced the details and the outline of the plans, but I have come to the conclusion that it is absolutely necessary to give the legitimate discontent and the rage in the Negro community a channel for expression. This we fully intend to do through the Southern Christian Leadership Conference.
Now that you've finished this jail sentence, how do you look upon having to have served that, sir?
Well, as I said, I was sad about the fact that the Supreme Court rendered what I considered a very unfortunate and bad decision. Not only bad for civil rights, but bad for the labor movement, bad for First Amendment privileges. I feel that this decision will only give license to bigots and racists to abuse the judicial process in order to block First Amendment privileges. On the other hand, I went to jail willingly and cheerfully, because I've always said if you break a law or disobey a court order that conscience tells you is unjust, you must willingly accept the penalty. And we willingly accepted, we volunteered and surrendered. And I would say beyond that, that all that the Birmingham movement accomplished for this nation in terms of a civil rights bill and an impetus in many other areas, our jail sentence was a small price to pay.
What was the purpose, sir, in having you move from the Bessemer jail over here?
We don't know all of the reasons. Two or three reasons came to us. I mean, two or three expressions came to us. It was said that we were being moved because I could get better medical care in the Birmingham jail. A second reason was given, and that was a fear that the demonstrations taking place in Bessemer would, I don't think the answer is through riots, neither do I think the answer is through timid supplications for justice. And I think the middle ground is a massive movement of nonviolence, even taking on the dimensions of civil disobedience, whereby it will be possible to dislocate and to call attention to the evil situation, to dramatize it without destroying life or property.
Quiet together. Tackle, yep. Baptist Church.
Yes, sir.
And we expect to see you and all freedom-loving people tonight.
All right. All roads lead to Tabernacle. All roads. Tonight at 7 o'clock. We hope to see you there.
Did you?
Yeah, I don't know where
to go. Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
Always have warm memories.
Tell your friends tonight, Tabernacle.
How you doing?
This way.
Hey. How you doing?
Right.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Come here, dollar. Would you leave here?
You
better
not
leave. You gonna bring it here?
Yeah, I thought you were in Chicago.
They want to get us over to the motel. We'll meet y'all at the motel. You all must have some bugging system.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh!
How you all doing? All right, all right.
We